playing at the moment.
Yeah,
but
no. Hello everyone, welcome back to the Full Time Podcast. We're with Will from Was It a Penalty Podcast. Go and subscribe, there'll be a link in the description. And it'll be shown on screen. How you doing?
Good, thank you.
Good. We're going to talk about some different football-y things. And we're going to start with whether Ten Hag should be sacked. They've lost 3-0 in the last two games to Man City and Newcastle. Lots of Man United fans are saying that that Ten Hag should be sacked.
Good.
Do you think he should?
It's a tough one, that, because I know they've been beaten a lot this season, especially getting beat other night to Newcastle. Yes and no, if you know what I mean, because
yeah. He had 7 defeats in 14 games.
Well, I think he should be sacked personally, because he's just not getting them going or anything. He just needs to build up a squad that will win games, and he obviously can't do that. So yeah, I think he should be sacked.
Yeah, I mean, who would replace him?
People have been saying Zidane. Which,
Zidane.
I don't think he will.
Yeah. Would any managers leave their current jobs and teams to go to Man U, do you think? Or
not how they're playing at the moment.
Yeah,
but
not from any big teams. Unai Emery was one that I actually saw.
Mm.
But I don't think, with how Villa are doing, I don't think he'd...
Maybe Graham Potter.
Go.
Graham Potter.
Maybe, yeah. I mean, you look at Ten Hag's choices, right, and you look at their defence. Onana, who they spent, forgot how much, he was pretty expensive.
60
million. He's not performed too well. Their defence looks very shaky. I mean, his decision for the Man City game, he put Lindelof instead of Reguilon. He put Evans instead of Varane.
Mm.
And then he took Amrabat off for Mount when they were 2-0 down, when he's the only defensive cover in the midfield, you know.
Mm.
So I think he's making a lot of mistakes. Mm. I do think he should be sacked. But, yeah. Do you think he should?
Yeah.
Cause I think Potter should come in then for him.
Well, or maybe, but we'll just have to see who comes in and if he gets sacked. But, like, Hoyland's been playing really well, and he takes Hoyland off, and the crowd boo him all the time.
Yeah.
For, like, Rashford. Rashford comes on usually. Mount, I don't know why they bought Mount, because I think
60 million.
When you've got Fernandes, and you've got Casemiro, and then you've got Amrabat on a loan, I don't see the point of them paying 60 million for Mount.
Yeah, they did need more attacking options, and Mount didn't seem too happy at Chelsea. They just lack a leader, and they lack the sort of fight to play. Like, it's like how Chelsea were, you know, with all their individual players, that they spent £1 billion now in the last 12 months. They have no, like, passion for the badge, it doesn't seem. But, yeah. So we were saying Ten Hag should be sacked.
Yeah, he should be sacked. And I think if tomorrow, if he does beat Fulham, they've got an easy run after that. And if he wins all them games, you never know. But I think he should be sacked. And if he don't win tomorrow, I think that city's out. They were saying after the Newcastle game that he should have been gone after that. And he hasn't been. So I think tomorrow could be his last days as Man United manager.
Yeah. Everyone was saying that how, you know, last season they came fourth, and Ten Hag, that was sort of his settling in season, everything. And now, this was supposed to be a season where they, I don't know, challenge for the league or something.
Yeah.
I thought they'd come second, which was just...
I thought they'd win it.
Yeah. But no, they're just, even their signings, like most of them, unless Hoyland can suddenly do something. They've not worked.
Mm-hmm.
And Casemiro, who was pretty good, he got a few red cards, but he's old, you know, and that's probably why he got in Amrabat, and now he's playing other people in the midfield. But yeah, I think he should be sacked as well. Did Messi deserve the Ballon d'Or? Do you think? I just thought it was all quite, I don't know. Robbed and everything. Have you seen, you know, Emi Martinez got the, the goalkeeping award?
Mm.
He ranked first in that, obviously.
Mm.
And then in the proper Ballon d'Or rankings, he ranked second out of all the goalkeepers. And Bonu was 13th, he was 15th. And yet he won the goalkeeper award. I don't get that.
I think because Messi and Martinez got them only because they won the World Cup.
Yeah.
I think that's why.
Yeah, although, fair play, he basically single-handedly took Argentina to win it.
Mm.
But it's a four-week competition, and if you're basing it through the whole season, I think Haaland had to win it.
Oh, yeah.
What he's done. Like,
won the treble?
Yeah, won the treble, all his goal records and everything in the Prem and for Man City.
Mm-hmm.
In his first season as well.
Yeah.
I think it was quite quite biased, yeah. And you could tell. Everyone's now saying that, like, the GOAT debate was over and everything with Ronaldo and Messi from Ballon d'Ors now, whereas half of what Messi's got from Ballon d'Or wise is not really deserved, yeah. And half of what Ronaldo has got from Ballon d'Ors is deserved. So yeah, it's all quite weird to do with that. I think you have to base it, if you're doing that sort of thing, you have to base it more on the player throughout their whole career than if they've won a Ballon d'Or, you know, that can be biased towards different players. Because if Messi's won the World Cup, got the Ballon d'Or, then where's Mbappe's 2018 or Modric's Ribery from when he won it, we're going to do a Premier League team of the season. So far,
right.
I've wrote mine down, whether you can agree with me or not.
Yeah.
And in goal, you'll probably agree with me as Alisson.
Yeah. He's kept loads of clean sheets. Yeah.
Clean sheets. He's preventing tons of goals. And Liverpool are doing really well, aren't they?
Yeah.
So
good.
Back four, from right to left, I've got Trippier.
Yeah, I'd have gone with him. Yeah.
Saliba. You have to own Saliba, don't you? And then I've got some stats for this one. Anderson from Crystal Palace.
He has been playing well this season as Anderson.
Yeah. So, I mean, to say he's a defender, he's created 10 chances in 10 games, 2 goals in 10 games, and 100% successful dribbles.
Mm. Yeah.
So that's what I saw and thought, well, I don't know anyone with better stats than that.
Well,
so far,
well, Van Dijk, but he hasn't been performing. If he wouldn't have got that injury, I'd have said he was the best defender in the world. After that injury, he's just come off it.
It's what happens to a lot of players, isn't it, like that. Do you agree with that then? And then I've got Destiny Udogie at left back from Spurs. And then midfield three of Rodri, Maddison and Julian Alvarez.
Oh, nope. I wouldn't have Alvarez in. I'd have Szoboszlai in. Well, they're both different players, should we say. Because Alvarez is more like a striker, isn't he?
Yeah.
And Szoboszlai can actually score really good goals. So can Alvarez.
Yeah, I suppose if this was like a team that would be playing next week, I'd probably have Szoboszlai, because it's all really attacking players in this team, and you'd need someone to. So maybe I've gone with Alvarez just for probably attacking stats more than defensive ones. Front three, I don't think you'll agree with me on this one. You'll agree with me with Salah and Haaland, yeah?
Not Salah.
Not Salah?
No.
I'll tell you the three, because you might have. So, Salah, Haaland, and then Bowen. It was between Bowen and Saka for me, and Bowen had more goals and more assists.
Yeah, I'd have that. So I'd have Bowen, Haaland, and Saka. I won't have Salah.
Okay, I didn't actually look at Saka or Salah.
But I know Salah has scored a few goals this season. I think because Salah's getting old now, and like 5 years ago he was unbelievable, but now he's come off it a bit, and I think Saka's probably a good attacking.
Yeah, he's young as well, so he's got his old career,
he's got good potential. So is Martinelli as well.
Yeah, I may change Salah then.
Yeah. I was thinking, like, would you have Trippier though? I might have Walker. Walker right back. Mm. Walker as, and Trippier.
Yeah, I mean, as I said, defensively, it's not a brilliant team, so defensively you'd want Walker. Trippier though, he's got like, I think 5 assists or something in 9 or 10 games, which I just thought, well, it has to be, you know. Yeah, I don't know. I'll have to have a look at it. But maybe Saka instead of Salah. Can Tottenham win the league?
No.
You said no before. They've got Chelsea next, and there's a lot of. I've heard some Tottenham fans say that it could be 5 or 6-0 against Chelsea. It's at Tottenham.
Yeah.
And that. I mean, it like Brentford went to Chelsea and it didn't really
make
that much of a difference. So I don't know whether home games give Chelsea any advantage. To be honest, I think Spurs will win. But just from what all Spurs fans are saying, are they like a bit too loud? Like
they're like Arsenal last season. They're like, oh, we're gonna win the league, and then it came to that final week for Arsenal, which they just bottled it. Which I'm glad.
The Southampton draw.
Yeah, but no, it's too early on into the season to say who's gonna win the league. In my opinion, they will not win the league.
They'll bottle it. Like
I think they'll come fourth. I think they'll drop down. I think because they've got a tough Christmas. I think that they've got Chelsea, they've got Arsenal. No, they haven't. They've got Chelsea, they've got Man City, and they've got Aston Villa. They're their 4-3 games coming up. And I think, as well, they've got Chelsea. I think they could bottle it with that as well.
I mean, in big games, they played Arsenal and got a draw, which was good, and everyone thought, well, you know, Spurs are back.
Yeah.
But against Liverpool, Liverpool got robbed, to be honest. Yeah,
properly.
Like, they played all right, Spurs, but I don't think they would have beaten you if it weren't for that
poor
decision. And it's just like we say it with VAR all the time, like, it could shape a season. If Spurs win the league by 1 point and Liverpool miss out,
I'll be fuming. I'll be absolutely fuming.
The VAR's done that, you know. So,
but VAR just ruined everything, though. That's the thing.
Do you think there should just be no VAR?
I think
scrap it all.
If they're gonna keep it, at least put people that know what they're doing into it. Like, I think they should have from different nationalities reffing. Because if you watch the Champions League and the Europa League, they're completely better refs than the ones in the Premier League. Premier League refs are rubbish.
Even just English refs.
Oh, yeah, they don't know what they're doing.
Like, I think VAR, if they're going to change it, they should have, maybe like you said, a different nationality. Just one person on VAR looking at it and making the decision. Because in the audio that we saw with the Liverpool-Spurs one, there was like 10 different people all talking over each other, you know, so they didn't know what decision it was, and they didn't know what to tell the ref.
Yeah.
Like, it must be chaos for the ref trying to ref the game and then talk to like 20 people at once.
Yeah, because when I listened to that, they said, oh, it's no goal. So then the assistant says, no, you've got to stop and give it. And I was thinking the person who didn't give the goal, I think he were a Tottenham fan, or he just didn't want Liverpool to win, or give him the goal. Because he was miles onside, if you look at it. He was miles onside. So
I don't know how they managed to get it wrong.
Yeah, I don't know.
It's one of the most obvious decisions you'll get, and then not pulling it back after.
I know.
Like, There was a game, I've forgotten what it was, but there was a game where there was a penalty that was called 5 minutes after the decision that it wasn't a penalty. It's fine to stop the game and pull it back. Mm. It's not like anyone's going to be really frustrated with that, you know. Anyway, back to Tottenham if they can win the league. No.
Is that I think they don't have the depth, and I think they've got the team.
Postecoglou, can he?
But I think if one player goes like badly injured, like Maddison,
yeah,
they're done. They're absolutely done. But yeah, I don't think they'll win the league. I think they'll come third or fourth. And I think they'll drop points against, like, the teams. Like, they'll lose against Liverpool, I think, at Anfield. They won't beat City. They won't beat Arsenal, even though they've drawn to Arsenal. But I think...
If it's at Spurs?
Yeah. It's not a hard place to go to Spurs. Because there's no fans, so... but no, I don't think they'll win league. And okay. It's too early to call, so...
Yeah, I suppose so. I think...
After Christmas, you'll...
Yeah, do you think Man City can, like... Because they've had, what, three bad games and now everyone's sending...
They'll run away with it.
Yeah.
I think it'll be Liverpool and Man City this year, and...
No Arsenal.
No. I think they'll run away with it, or they'll either bottle it like we saw against Wolves. I think Tottenham haven't got a chance this season. People have been saying, oh, they're going to win the league... Nah, it's too early to call. I think after December, you'll look at table and you think, oh, the two teams at top, and it all depends on the points as well.
Yeah. I mean, it usually happens at the start of the season where there's like five or six teams that are in the title race. Like Villa's in there.
Oh, yeah.
People were saying that Villa could do a Leicester this season and go and win it.
Yeah, Leicester.
Maybe.
Yeah, nah.
But yeah, let's do a Chelsea-Tottenham combined 11 for this weekend.
Oh, great.
I'll just do what we did for the Premier League one. Read it out. You can agree with me. Vicario in goal over Sanchez.
Yeah.
You think?
Yeah.
Because really, the goalie that's doing better is probably higher up in the league.
That's right, yeah.
And he's got a higher save percentage or something than Sanchez. Reece James, right back, over who?
Porro,
yeah. I'd say so, wouldn't you?
Yeah, but I don't know. That's a difficult one because
if Liverpool play next week and they could get either Reece James, if they had to play either Reece James or Porro, you'd have Reece James.
Yeah.
Lost it. Van de Ven and Romero. Two. That's over, what, Thiago Silva. And Romero... Romero's got more goals than Thiago Silva. Obviously, it's defenders, so... And just better defensive stats overall than Thiago Silva. Van de Ven is probably the best Spurs defender at the moment.
Mm-hmm.
And there's no Chelsea defender that can really... and then it was between Udogie and Chilwell, but we came up with Udogie for the full on-form Premier League 11. In the midfield, Bissouma, Maddison and Enzo Fernandez over Sarr.
Well, yeah.
I'd say so, yeah. And then front three, Son, Sterling and Palmer. Palmer over... Kulusevski or Richarlison.
And Sterling over Kulusevski as well.
Or Richarlison, yeah.
Yeah.
So Sterling and Palmer over Kulusevski and Richarlison.
I think I'd have picked Kulusevski over Sterling, but the form that Sterling's been in at the moment, I would pick Sterling.
Okay.
He's been scoring quite a few goals this season. I think, yeah, he's good, good striker.
Even Cole Palmer. Probably Chelsea's best signing. Out of the billion they've spent, he's probably one of the best.
It was the midfielders again. There was...
Enzo Fernandez, Bissouma and Maddison. Obviously Maddison.
Oh, yeah. But I would have picked Caicedo or Lavia over...
Bissouma.
Yeah, but they don't play. That's the thing. Yeah. And Lavia's not even getting a game. He's not even on the subs bench.
No. I think Caicedo's gone, like, out of the picture now. That, you know that mistake against West Ham where he pen? He's just not...
He's made the wrong decision by going there.
What do you think should have gone? Liverpool?
I think he should have stayed at Brighton.
Yeah, well, I suppose so, yeah. Mm. They would have had a good team if Caicedo was on form and still there.
Mm.
Let's rank... Hold on. We got two more. We're going to rank the biggest Premier League signings, biggest or just because Kai Havertz isn't a big signing.
The best.
But he was one, like, well, the Kai Havertz was a big signing at the time.
Mm, but now,
obviously, he's crap now.
Yeah.
Let's rate them out of 10. So right. I'll go through them all and we can both rate them out of 10. Kai Havertz to Arsenal.
About a 5.
For 65 million.
About a 4 or 5 out of 10.
I'd say 4.
Yeah.
Or 5 generously. Whoever got that money from off Chelsea, then, well, fair play. Because, Kai Havertz was good for Chelsea and now he's just crap for Arsenal.
Yeah, he's a rush.
They go through in teams. So Declan Rice to Arsenal. For 105 million. Some people, Arsenal fans are saying that it's a bargain now. 105 million.
I'd go 7 out of 10.
I'd go 8. He's like one of the best players at Arsenal, I'd say, so far this season. He didn't get into our so far Premier League 11, though. Alvarez, Madison and Rodri, did he?
Yeah, no.
No. Timber to Arsenal. For only 38 million, he's got the injury now, but
he was zero.
Okay, yeah.
Only because he got the injury, but it's a good signing. So
okay, if he didn't get the injury, I think he'd be
about 7 or 8.
Probably, yeah. Mm. I go 4. just from what he did in four games he played.
Yeah.
Caicedo to Chelsea for 115 million.
Blooming hell, 2.
1.
Yeah.
He's like, he came on, gave away a pen.
He's rubbish.
Yeah. Came on, gave away a pen, and now he's just.
Yeah.
He's done nothing. I can't remember anything. I've crossed off Nkuku because he's got he's injured now till August next year.
Oh my God, what's the point of that?
He was 62 million, I think. No?
Oh my God.
52 million.
Blimey.
Yeah, 52 million. And he's injured till August. He's out for the whole season. And it's probably going to be one of the ones... It's going to be worse than Van Dijk's. He's going to come back and he's just going to be...
Just rubbish.
Rubbish, isn't he? Cole Palmer for 43 million. I'd say...
About 7.
Yeah, 7 for the money.
Mm-hmm.
Because he's one of the shining lights at Chelsea, I'd say.
Yeah.
So far. Alexis McAllister to Liverpool. I'll let you start. You watch more Liverpool than me.
I'd say a 4.
A 4?
Mm. He's rubbish. I'd say... okay. I wouldn't say he's rubbish, but I would...
For 35 million...
That's, yeah, good amount of money, but... Like, when you watch him, he just gives the ball away all the time. He doesn't trap back or anything. For the money, I'd give it a 7, but he's playing about 5.
Yeah, all right, I'll go 5 as well then. Yeah. Szoboszlai to Liverpool. You love Szoboszlai to Liverpool.
10.
60 million.
10.
10?
Yeah.
I'll go 8.
Well, he's unbelievable. Playmaker. When I watched him against West Ham, he was unbelievable. Bringing balls all over. He was unbelievable. And that strike against Leicester. Oh, God.
No, that was pretty good, wasn't it? Guardiola. From RB Leipzig to Man City, he was 78 million, and he's not played too much. When he has played, he's been all right. He's been like a average Stones, not like the Stones that everyone thought is like brilliant. Now he's like, meh. Yeah, he's right. Not worth almost 80 million, is he?
No, yeah. I'd give him
6. I'd go
about 5 or 6. Yeah, give it 6.
Yeah. Mason Mount to Man United.
0?
He's 60 million, he was.
Ah, yeah. With the amount of, well, the amount of money that they paid for him, I'd say about a 3 or 4.
Yeah, I'm going 3. Onana for almost 50 million to Man United.
1.
Yeah, I'll go 1. He's only got 1 because of that penalty save against Copenhagen.
Yeah, well, so he hasn't done as much.
He's not, like, he's probably conceded more goals than he's saved shots.
Yeah, well, people have been like saying this is his start of season, and next season is going to be unbelievable. But I've heard that...
He'll probably be gone by next season.
I've heard that Man United want De Gea back.
I think they should have kept him. I mean, at the time, I thought they should have let him go, but now, obviously, I think they should have kept him.
Yeah.
De Gea, with Ten Hag coming in, he wants, like, a good passer around the back or whatever. Onana can do that, he just can't save shots. But De Gea is a rubbish passer and rubbish on the ball, but he can save
shots. Oh, he's a good keeper,
He is, yeah. I've crossed off Tonali because you know what happened with Tonali. Yeah. Madison for 40 million, I'd go
8 or 9. I'll go 8.5.
Okay.
How much was it for?
40. 40 million.
Not bad. Yeah, I'd go about 9.
For at the moment, arguably the best player in the league, I'd say, wouldn't you?
Yeah, yeah.
Like,
at the moment.
What, top 3? Probably. Yeah. Let's go. Only 40 million, considering other players that teams have bought. Although you only bought Szoboszlai for 60.
Not bad.
20 million more. Yeah, I'm going 9. Almost 10.
Yeah.
James, and then the West Ham ones. James Ward-Prowse for only 30 million. Oh. I'd go 8.
I haven't watched him much, but when I have watched him, he's been a good player. So yeah, I'd go for about 7.
I'd say he's not at the moment with how Rice is doing at Arsenal, but from what Rice did at West Ham, he's just as good.
Yeah.
And then I don't think you'll know him that well. You know Mohamed Kudus?
Is it the black lad?
Yeah, yeah. I've watched him. I've watched every game, and he never loses the ball. I've never seen him lose the ball. I've seen him lose the ball once, actually, and then he's sprinted and just got it back straight away.
Was that him who scored against Arsenal?
He's,
I'd go for 9.
What did I go for, Prowse? Like,
you're 7.
7. Yeah, it has to be 9 then. Yeah. For 38 million as well.
When did they buy him from?
Ajax. Have you seen Ajax?
Bottom of the league.
It's because they've lost to West Ham. They've lost Kudus and Alvarez, two of the best players. We've gone in and nicked them, and now they're in the mud. And Leon as well. You've seen?
Yeah.
I don't know what's happening with
falling down like Man United.
I heard a Man U fan. This is completely off topic, but I heard a Man U fan actually say that relegation would be good for them. Because they've been able to rebuild their team.
Says them.
But, yeah, I suppose. And then, last one. Will Liverpool win the league? We've talked about Tottenham. Can Liverpool do it?
I'd like to think so, but it's too early. Okay. I'd say...
With their team, they're 1 point from the top at the moment.
I'd want to
say... And that's only because... Well, yeah, it is only because they got robbed at Spurs, to be honest.
I think if we beat Man City at home and away, I think we'll win the league.
Think they'll drop enough points then to do it? I mean, they've already dropped to Wolves and...
They beat Wolves. Beat Wolves and drawn... No, got beat to Tottenham.
Yeah.
Oh, they've drawn someone else, haven't they? They've drawn 2 games.
They have. No, Wolves beat him 2-1.
No, we beat him 3-1.
No, I mean Man City.
Oh, Man City. Oh. Man City, yeah.
Yeah. Do you think they'll win the league then? Is it just if you beat Man City?
I think
because
we'll beat...
Because even Arsenal and Spurs, will they be anywhere? No. Nope.
It'll be us and City, and I think we'll beat them at home.
When do you think they'll fall off, Arsenal and Spurs? After Christmas, maybe.
Maybe just in Christmas.
Christmas?
Before Christmas, maybe. But I think we will beat City at home. I don't know about beating them away. I think we'll beat them at home. If we beat them away, I think we'll go on and win the league. But we haven't won the league for 4 years. And the only... We won the league that time. God knows how we won the league. But Man City were rubbish.
It was in COVID as well, so no fans. Well,
especially 30 years as well.
Yeah. Oh, well. Yeah. I mean, there was a lot of panic, wasn't there, when Fabinho left, Henderson left. And then, like, Caicedo went to Chelsea, didn't he? Bellingham, who we
I thought we wouldn't get a replacement.
But, and obviously now it's like their midfield issue just gone now because of...
I don't think it's fully gone. I think we should get a DM. We need to get a DM. We need to get like a Fabinho again.
Yeah.
Like, I think the best midfield was when we won the league with Fabinho, Wijnaldum and Henderson. That was the best midfield that we had. And I love watching...
Can this compete then? Your midfield now?
I think McAllister, if he grows a bit and he's comes out as a good player, I'd say yeah. But I think one more player would do it.
Yeah.
A DM probably.
Do you think then you can beat, like, the big teams up there?
Yeah.
Spurs, I mean...
Well, we should have beaten Spurs. Yeah,
to be honest. Who else? And then Arsenal.
We haven't even had anyone. We've only had Tottenham, have we?
Yeah.
Arsenal, yeah, beat them. Man United, 7-0.
Yeah. I don't know how many that'll be, to be honest, when you're playing.
It depends if he goes as well.
Even like Villa. What about Villa away?
Tough game.
Imagine Monday night at Villa. That's hard, isn't it?
Villa Park as well.
Yeah.
Unbelievable. Villa... Brighton.
Brighton, yeah. West Ham?
At the moment, yeah.
Well, maybe. You never know.
I tell you who else is a hard place to go. Fulham's ground. Fulham's quite hard to go to and win. But Man City have got Fulham... Man United have got Fulham tomorrow.
Is that Fulham? Yeah. Although it's 12:30, which...
They're dodgy.
I think night games... I think night games and 12:30s are good. Night games are better.
Oh, yeah.
3 o'clock's a...
Yeah.
You know, they're all right. The 4:30 on Sundays are the best, though.
Oh, yeah, love them.
Most goals, aren't they?
Yeah.
That's all.
Yep.
Cheers for watching, everyone.
Thank you.
See you next time.
See you. Thanks, Callum.
I will.
See you.
Very good. See you next time. Goodbye.
Goodbye.